curtains back, the Baptist cry announces that the Lord is nigh. Awake and hearken, for he brings glad tidings of the King of Kings. Then cleansed be every soul from sin, make straight the way of God within. Prepare we in our hearts a home where such a mighty guest may come. For thou art our salvation, Lord, our refuge and our sure reward. Shine forth and let thy light restore our souls to heavenly grace once more. All praise eternal Son to thee, whose advent set thy people free.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault, therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Kyrie eleison. Kyrie eleison. Christe eleison. Christe.
Let us pray. Almighty and merciful God, may no earthly undertaking hinder those who set out in haste to meet your Son, but may our learning of heavenly wisdom gain us admittance to his company, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Comfort, give comfort to my people, says your God. Speak tenderly to Jerusalem and proclaim to her that her service is at an end. Her guilt is expiated. Indeed, she has received from the hands of the Lord double for all her sins. A voice cries out in the desert, prepare a way for the Lord. Make straight in the wasteland a highway for our God. Every valley shall be filled in, every mountain and hill shall be made low. The rugged land shall be made a plain, the rough country a broad valley. Then the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all the people shall see it together, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken. Go up onto a high mountain, Zion, herald of glad tidings. Cry out at the top of your voice, Jerusalem, herald of good news. Fear not to cry out and say to the cities of Judah, here is your God. Here comes with power the Lord God, who rules by a strong arm. Here is his reward with him, his recompense before him. Like a shepherd, he feeds his flock. In his arms, he gathers the lambs, carrying them to his bosom and leading the ewes with care. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Reading from the second letter of St. Peter. Do not ignore this one fact, beloved, that with the Lord one day is like 1,000 years, and 1,000 years like one day. The Lord does not delay his promise, as some regard delay, but he is patient with you, not wishing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance. But the day of the Lord will come like a thief, and then the heavens will pass away with a mighty roar, and the elements will be dissolved by fire, and the earth and everything done on it will be found out. Since everything is to be dissolved in this way, what sort of persons ought you to be? Conducting yourself in holiness and devotion, waiting for and hastening the coming of the day of God, because of which of the heavens will be dissolved in flames, and the elements melted by fire. But according to his promise, we await new heavens and a new earth, in which righteousness dwells. Therefore, beloved, since you await these things, be eager to be found without spot or blemish before him, at peace. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord.
The beginning of the Gospel of Jesus Christ, the Son of God. As it is written in Isaiah the prophet, "Behold, I am sending my messenger ahead of you. He will prepare your way. A voice of one crying out in the desert, 'Prepare the way of the Lord, make straight his path.'" John the Baptist appeared in the desert, proclaiming a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins. People of the whole Judean countryside and all the inhabitants of Jerusalem were gone out to him and were being baptized by him in the Jordan River as they acknowledged their sins. John was clothed in camel's hair with a leather belt around his waist. He fed on locusts and wild honey. And this is what he proclaimed: "One mightier than I is coming after me. I am not worthy to stoop and loosen the thongs of his sandals. I have baptized you with water. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good morning, everyone. Are you ready for Christmas? Did you already send your Christmas cards? The gifts are wrapped, nothing yet? Are you done with your Christmas shopping? No? Nothing in Amazon, nothing, not yet? Why not? Christmas is in how many more days? 18 days? We're late. But how about for Jesus? Are we ready for Jesus? Sometimes we only pay attention to what we see. Sometimes we are done with our Christmas shopping, our Christmas gift, our Christmas meal. We are done with our flights that people will come to us. That's beautiful, because Christmas is about love. Christmas is about family. Christmas is about tradition. But how about faith? How about the reason for Christmas? Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. The manger is still empty. Beautiful statue of St. Joseph, the Blessed Mother, the shepherds, the sheep. But how about the manger itself? Someone is missing there. I hope that that missing person there is not missing here as well. Because if we miss Jesus in our souls, in our lives, Christmas is just another holiday. And this is the main point in today's Holy Gospel. Prepare the way of the Lord. Prepare the way for the Lord. Prepare your life for the one who is coming. Not for me, for you. Jesus became human for me because of my love, because of my salvation. But how is that God became human for me? What does he need from me? He need my love. He need my life. Because the one who created me is the one who inspired me words of hope and faithfulness to go back to him. Life is not a challenge. Life is a journey with God. In this journey, not everything is going to be perfect and beautiful. There will be a lot of up and downs. Today you are all the way up. You are, oh my Lord, I'm the best Christian in the world. But tomorrow we can be down. However, God is also there. He's preparing our ways, our souls, our hearts to make them straight. What is Christmas all about? Christmas lights, they're beautiful, by the way. Christmas toys, that's so awesome. Christmas meals, the best thing ever. Family, now we're getting the point. Christmas is about that, the family of God getting together to share love, to share mercy, to prepare the way of the Lord. John the Baptist appeared in the desert. John the Baptist proclaimed that the Lord is coming. In the same way, Jesus is sending us to prepare the way, to remind our people, especially now, that even though this virus has changed our society, has changed our world, there is still hope. There is still God in our lives. There is still faith on earth. We can change everything. Prepare the way of the Lord. Make straight his path. John the Baptist teaches us that we don't have to be perfect to belong to God. We are imperfect people. We are sinners. And that is the reason of the incarnation, the forgiveness of our sins. Are we not forgiven from God? We are always forgiven. Why not to do the same with my neighbor? Why not to spread forgiveness to others? Why not to become messengers of hope when people are hopeless nowadays? Why not to bring that smile in a world which is upsetting, in a world which is sad? Why not to bring peace, joy, patience, kindness, as the first reading says? Why not? Is not Christmas, is not Jesus a reason enough to make straight his path? The Lord wants to fix us. The Lord wants to cure us. The Lord wants to heal us. And why not Christmas? During Christmas, why not for Christmas? Why do we have to wait until Lent or Easter or next year? Why not today? Prepare the way of the Lord. Prepare your way, prepare my way. I have to prepare my way. When Jesus comes, and I love this passage. Remember the night that Jesus was born? Mary and Joseph went to different houses, knocking doors. Please, please, give us a shelter. Please, my wife is having a child. Please, welcome us. We are strangers. In the same way, Jesus is saying, I'm coming to you. May I have some room? No, Lord, I'm busy. Lord, come back later. Lord, not right now. I come to you. And I don't have my hands empty. I have so many blessings, so many graces. I offer you the best thing ever, divine life, eternal life. Please open the door for me. Lord, welcome to my life. Please come in. And not only you, bring your holy mother, bring Saint Joseph with you. Please come to my place. Because I want to make my path straight. Never is late, my brothers and my sisters, to make straight our path. Never is late to come back to Jesus. Never is late to change. Never is late for repentance. Never is late for forgiveness. Because the Lord of Lords is the King of all of us. You need mercy, ask for it. You need for compassion, ask for it. Whatever you need, please ask for it. And it will be granted to you. Because he comes for me, he comes for you, he comes for everybody, especially now when our world needs him. Let us open the doors of our souls in such a wide way that he can come with all the angels and saints and make his manger here. As he came to Bethlehem 2,000 years ago, he's ready to come to your place and stay with you, not only for one day, but forever. My brothers, my sisters, the responsorial psalm says, Lord, let us see your kindness and grant us your salvation. The Lord is kind and merciful. The Lord always forgives. The Lord is always for us, in us, and through us. And that is the beauty of our God, that even though we are sinners, He forgives us and He loves us in such a beautiful way that He also gives us His beloved mother, the Blessed Virgin Mary. As we are going to celebrate her feast, the Immaculate Conception feast date on Tuesday, let us rely on her intercession. Let us come back to our beautiful and heavenly mother and say, Dear Mother, make me yours. Bring me back to Jesus. Come back to my life. She, as a good mother, will accept all our prayers, all our intentions. She will even read the thoughts of our minds and hearts. Come back to Jesus through Mary, and all things will be different. If you love the Son, you have to love the Mother. If you believe in the Mother, you will love the Son forever. May Mother and Son always bless us and protect us as we prepare ourselves for the coming of our Lord and Savior. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. If you have your book, please go to page number 9. Now stand and together let us proclaim our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in the Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. Lord, you give comfort and peace to your people. We come before you with all our prayers, which comes from the bottom of our hearts.
For our Holy Father, Pope Francis, and all the bishops and priests, that they will shepherd the church with wisdom and loving compassion. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For civil servants and government officials, that they will provide to comfort those who seek assistance. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who carry new life and those who are searching for a reason to enjoy it, that they may be comforted in the hope and inspirations life brings, as well as its joys and responsibilities. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who dwell in residences of assisted living and extended care, and for their caregivers, that they provide a nurturing environment of loving patients. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For members of our community, especially those who are unable to be with us this day, that we all may faithfully await new heavens and a new earth. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our sick, George Rudis, Julia Ramos, Michael Cena, Luciana Rodriguez, baby Stephen Hernandez, and those listed in the bulletin, that the Lord will restore them to health. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those that have died in the peace of Christ, Joaquin Benjamin Salser, Rosa Marietta Curiela Cabrera, Elizabeth Warnock, Peter Garcia, Walter F. Garcia, Julio Pata, Melvin Schwenick, and especially for Rosemary Rooney and Angelina DeLuca, that they may be welcomed into the company of the saints. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. In a moment of silence, let us present to God everything we bring in our hearts. God of goodness, grace, and mercy, as we follow the advice of this prophet Isaiah, we want to prepare ourselves for the coming of your Son, as you receive all our prayers through Christ our Lord. Please be seated. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Be pleased, O Lord, with our humble prayers and offerings. And since we have no merits to plead our cause, come, we pray, to our rescue with the protection of your mercy, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he assumed at his first coming the lowliness of human flesh, and so fulfilled the design you formed long ago, and opened for us the way to eternal salvation, that when he comes again in glory and majesty, and all is at last made manifest, we who watched for that day may inherit the great promise in which now we dare to hope. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Sanctus, Sanctus, Sanctus Dominus Deus Sabaoth, Lini sunt celi et terra, gloria tua, Hosanna in excelsis, benedictus qui venit in nomine Domini, Hosanna in excelsis.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, this gift, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Timothy, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. In a few seconds of silence, let us pray for our deceased ones. For Rosemary Rowney, for Angelina De Luca, and for all those who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said through your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you. Peace be with you. Peace be with you.
Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccato mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccato mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccato
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Jerusalem, arise and stand upon the heights, and behold the joy which comes to you from God.
For the reception of the Most Holy Communion, The advice is that people must receive the Holy Eucharist in the hand. But at the end, it's up to the communicant to decide if you receive in the hand or in the, on the tongue. But the preference is that you must receive in the hand. Also, you cannot walk away with the host. You have to step aside, remove your mask, and consume the host in front of the priest, just to be sure that the Holy Eucharist is going inside. Please, we had some issues last week and the week before that people took the host with them to their homes. And that is a sacrilege. Please, take your host, remove your mask, put it in, put it back, okay? So hand or tongue is up to you. The preference in the hand. Please come forward.
God will dwell with you.
Just a couple of announcements before we go home. So as you know, this Tuesday, December the 8th, is the solemnity of the Immaculate Conception of the Blessed Virgin Mary. Even though this is a holy day of obligation, this year it is not, okay? Because of the pandemic. So if you can make it to church, you're more than welcome. If you cannot make it and you feel that you must stay at home and being safe, so just watch the mass and in the social media or in TV, therefore you are fulfilling the obligation. But if you want to come to church on Tuesday, remember that we have our Vigil Mass on Monday at 5, and we have three masses on Tuesday, 6 a.m., 7 a.m., and 5 p.m. here in church, okay? And also on Tuesday is the National Prayer Night for Life. There will be a holy hour here in the church from 9 p.m. to 1 a.m. 4 hours of prayers asking our Lord for the gift of life. This coming Saturday, December the 12th, is the feast day of Our Lady of Guadalupe. She's the patroness of the Americas. So if you love mariachis, join us on Saturday at 4 in the morning to sing the mañanitas to Our Lady. There will be a huge mariachi, you know, we're keeping the social distancing, all that stuff. There will be also a limited number of people in church. So the mañanitas is at 4 a.m. on Saturday, and the regular mass for Our Lady at 8 in the morning on the 12th. And finally, a week from today is our, because of the pandemic, we cannot have our Advent retreat, but we want to do something else, something stronger for Advent. So there will be a special holy hour here in church on Sunday the 13th at 3 p.m. with Father Justin Sinante, a Carmelite priest. So he's coming to lead the holy hour and also to give us a talk. All of that is for free. And now, as you know, this pandemic has brought a lot of good and bad to our world. One of the most affected people has been our kids. Peekskill is not a rich area. We have a lot of kids in need in elementary school, middle school. Every year, we host like a Christmas lunch for our kids. We give them lunch, we give them some toys, clothes, but this year is different. We came out with the idea to have a breakfast with Jesus. The kids will come. We're gonna give them some a nice breakfast to take home, and also, and perhaps give them some toys or clothes. But we need your help. If you are good making macaroni and cheese, salad, if you are good baking cookies or cakes, whatever you are good in your kitchen, please help us to feed the kids. It doesn't matter what you can provide. As long as it is cooked and ready to be served, that's more than welcome. You can call the rector and say, Father, my name is Esteban Sanchez. I'm gonna bake 25 brownies. Boom, that will help a lot. If you cannot make it, you can go, I don't know, to the dollar store and get some toys or something for the kids. That's also welcomed. If you go to your closet, your kids' closet, and there is something not new, not old, but something decent for our kids, is also more than welcome. Also, we got some statues in the back of the church for selling. All the profit we make from that selling will be used to buy some clothes and toys, or even pray for the meals for the 26th of December, which is a Saturday. So it's not for me, it's not for you, it's for those kids who have been experiencing a different Christmas, a different days lately. So help us to bring a nice smile to these kids' faces this year, that even though things are changing, and we are adults, and we're feeling it, now you can imagine our kids. So thank you so much for your time, for your prayers, and remember, prepare the way of the Lord. He's coming. Let us pray.
replenished by the food of spiritual nourishment, we humbly beseech you, O Lord, that through our partaking in this mystery, you may teach us to judge wisely the things of earth and hold firm to the things of heaven. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth. The Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Saint Michael, the Archangel,
defend us in battle. Be our defense against the wickedness and the snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, thrust into hell Satan and all other evil spirits who prowl throughout the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.
All the information can be found in the bulletin in the back of the church. Please take it with you and share that information with your neighbors. Have a blessed Sunday, everyone.
You too, Father.